In a previous class, we discussed about the DC motor working principle, construction, and its operation. In this lecture, we will study about operational characteristics of DC motor, characteristics of DC series motor, DC shunt motor, and characteristics of DC compound motor. Next, we will move on starting method of DC motor or how to start a DC motor. Need of starters for the DC motor. After this, we will move on. 2-point starter, what is it? The construction and working of 2-point starter, 3-point starter, and 4-point starter. Starters are used to start a DC motor. And finally, the reference of this presentation. So, in this presentation, we will learn all these topics one by one. Start with topic 1, characteristics of DC motor. Generally, three characteristics curve are considered important for DC motor, which are number 1, torque versus armature current characteristics, number 2, speed versus armature current, and number 3, speed versus torque characteristics. तो ये तीन characteristics होती हैं बहुत ही important in case of DC motor. इनका हम study करेंगे one by one. These are explained below for each type of DC motor. Tino characteristics ka hum study karenge for DC series motor, for DC shunt motor, and for DC compound motor. These characteristics are determined by keeping the following two relations in mind. Number 1, the torque is directly proportional to phi into Ia, where Ta is called the torque, phi A is called the flux, or Ia is called the armature current. And the second relation is N proportional to Eb by phi, where N is called the speed, Eb is called the back EMF, and phi is called the flux. These above equation can be studied at EMF and torque equation of the DC machine. For a DC motor, magnitude of back EMF is given by the same EMF equation of the DC generator, that is Eb is equal to phi Znp divided by 60 into A, where Eb is called the back EMF, P is called the number of poles, phi is called the flux, N is called the speed, and Z is called the number of conductor. 60 is a constant and A is equal to number of parallel path. For a machine, P, Z and A are constant. Therefore, we can say that speed N is proportional to Eb by phi. So the next topic is characteristics of DC series motor. So the first characteristics is torque versus armature current. Torque is denoted by Ta and armature current is denoted by Ia. This characteristics is also known as the electrical characteristics. We know that The torque is directly proportional to the product of armature current and field flux. That is TA proportional to phi into IA. In DC series motors, the field winding is connected in series with the armature. That is IA is equal to IF, means armature current is equal to field current. Therefore, before magnetic saturation of the field, flux phi is directly proportional to IA. Hence, before magnetic saturation, TA directly proportional to IA square, means torque is directly proportional to the square of the armature current. Therefore, TA and IA curve is parabola for smaller value of IA. After magnetic saturation of the field poles, the flux phi is independent of armature current IA. Therefore, the torque varies proportionally to IA only. So we can say that T proportional to IA. Therefore, after magnetic saturation, the TA and IA curve become a straight line. You can see the diagram, the characteristics of DC series motor, torque versus armature current. तो नॉर्मली जब हम आर्मेचर करंट को बढ़ाएंगे तो टॉर्क जो है वो हमारा इंक्रीज होगा. द शाफ्ट टॉर्क TSH इज लेस देन द आर्मेचर टॉर्क TA ड्यू टू स्ट्रे लॉसेस. हैज द कर्व TSH वर्सेस IA लाइज स्लाइटली लोअर. इन डीसी सीरीज मोटर्स the torque increases as the square of the armature current. These motors are used where the high starting torque is required. Now the next second characteristics, speed versus armature current. Speed is denoted by N and armature current is denoted by IA. We know that the relation N is proportional to EB by phi. For small load current and hence for small armature current, change in back EMF EB is small and it may be neglected. Hence, for small currents, speed is inversely proportional to phi. As we know, the flux is directly proportional to IA. So, speed is inversely proportional to IA. You can see the graph. This is the speed versus armature current graph. So, in a figure. Therefore, when the armature current is very small, the speed becomes dangerously high. That is why a series motor should never be started without some mechanical load. But at heavy loads, armature current IA is large and hence the speed is low, which result in decreased back EMF EB. Due to decreased the EB, more armature current is allowed. Next is a speed versus torque characteristics. Speed is denoted by capital N and torque is denoted by TA. This characteristics is also called as mechanical characteristics. So speed versus jo torque characteristics hoti hai usko hum mechanical characteristics bhi bolte hain. From the above two characteristics of the DC series motor, it can be found that when the speed is high, the torque is low and vice versa. So these are the three characteristics of the DC series motor. First one is called the torque versus armature current. Second is called speed versus armature current. And third one is called the speed versus torque characteristics. Now the next topic is characteristics of DC shunt motor. In case of DC shunt motors, we can assume that the field flux phi to be constant. True, at heavy loads, phi decreases in a small amount due to the increase of the armature reaction. As we are neglecting the change in the flux phi, we can say that the torque is proportional to the armature current. Hence, the TA and IA characteristics for a DC shunt motor will be a straight line through the origin. You can see the diagram. The characteristics is a straight line. And the second dotted line characteristics is called the shaft characteristics, TSH. Since heavy starting loads needs heavy starting currents, shunt motor should never be start on a heavy load. Next is the speed versus armature current characteristics. As flux phi is assumed to be constant, we can say the speed N is proportional to the back EMF EB. But as back EMF is also almost constant, the speed should remain constant. But practically, phi as well as EB decreases with increase in load. So back EMF EB decreases slightly more than phi. Therefore, the speed decreases slightly. This is so in a figure or the characteristics is speed versus armature current characteristics. Generally, the speed decreases only by 5 to 15% of full load speed. Therefore, a shunt motor can be assumed as a constant speed motor. In speed versus armature current characteristics, in the following figure, the straight horizontal line represents the ideal characteristics and the actual characteristics is shown by the dotted line. So these are three characteristics for DC shunt motor. First one is called torque versus armature current characteristics. Second one is called speed versus armature current. And third is called the speed versus torque characteristics for DC shunt motor. Now the next topic is the characteristics of DC compound motor. DC compound motor have both series as well as the shunt winding. In a compound motor, if the series and shunt windings are connected such that series flux in the direction as that of the shunt flux, then the motor is said to be cumulatively compound. And if the series flux is opposed to the direction of the shunt flux, then the motor is said to be differentially compound. Means compound motor are classified into two categories, cumulatively compound and differentially compound. So first one is cumulative compound motor. Cumulative compound motors are used where series characteristics are required, but the load is likely to be removed completely. Series winding takes care of heavy load, whereas the shunt winding prevents the motor from running at dangerously high speed when the load is suddenly removed. These motors have generally employed a flywheel where the sudden and temporary loads are applied like a rolling mills. Second one is a differentially compound motor. Since in differential field motors, series flux oppose shunt flux, the total flux decrease with increase in load. Due to this, the speed remains almost constant, or even it may be increased slightly with increasing in load, because N is proportional to EB by phi. Differential compound motors are not commonly used, but they find limited applications in experimental and research work. So these are the characteristics of DC compound motor. First one is called the torque versus armature current characteristics, and second is speed versus armature current characteristics. एक ही characteristics में सारी machine की characteristics को show किया है. Series DC motor, shunt DC motor, cumulative compound and differential compound, सारी जो motors हैं उनकी characteristics को एक साथ represent किया गया है. पहले वाले diagram में torque versus armature current and second is speed versus armature current. तो डायग्राम से हम क्लियरली देख सकते हैं कि सीरीज, शंट और कंपाउंड में क्या चेंज होगा जब हम आर्मेचर करंट को इंक्रीज करेंगे, तब टॉर्क और स्पीड में क्या चेंज होगा. नाउ द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज स्टार्टिंग ऑफ डीसी मोटर. So, a starter is a device to start and accelerate a motor. A controller is a device to start the motor, control and reverse the speed of the DC motor, and stop the motor. While starting the DC motor, it draws the heavy current which damages the motor. The starter reduces the heavy current and protect the system for damage. Actually DC जो motor होती है वो हमारी self starting नहीं होती है, इसमें हम starter का use करते हैं, because in a starting जो current होता है बहुत ही high होता है, starting में current heavy current flow होता है, तो उस current से जो machine की armature winding और field winding है वो damage हो सकती है. उसको प्रिवेंट करने के लिए हम स्टार्टर का यूज करते हैं. टू पॉइंट स्टार्टर, थ्री पॉइंट स्टार्टर और फोर पॉइंट स्टार्टर, ये कुछ स्टार्टर्स हैं जिनका हम यूज करते हैं टू स्टार्ट डीसी मोटर. सो स्टार्टर इज अ डिवाइस टू स्टार्ट और एक्सेलरेट अ मोटर. दिस इज अ सिंपल डेफिनेशन ऑफ द स्टार्टर. सो द क्वेश्चन ऑकर इन अवर माइंड, व्हाई वी नीड अ स्टार्टर. Need of starter for DC motor. The DC motor has no back EMF at the starting of the motor. जब motor on होती है तब उसका initially speed जो होता है वो zero होता है, और zero speed में back EMF की value जो होती है वो zero होती है, कुछ भी back EMF नहीं रहेगा. The armature current is controlled by the resistance of the circuit. The resistance of the armature is low, and when the full voltage is applied at standstill condition of the motor, the armature current become very high, which damage the part of the motor. Normally होता क्या है कि जब हमारी machine standstill condition में रुकी हुई condition में है और अगर हम उसको full voltage दे देंगे, तो जो resistance है जो कि oppose करता है current का, armature resistance in case of DC motor very low, low होता है बहुत ही. जब रेजिस्टेंस लो है तो हैवीली करंट फ्लो हो जाएगी मशीन में, तो उस हैवीली करंट से मशीन के आर्मेचर वाइंडिंग, फील्ड वाइंडिंग और सम पार्ट्स जो है वो डैमेज हो सकते हैं. सो टू प्रिवेंट फॉर डैमेजिंग ऑफ डीसी मशीन और डीसी मोटर इन स्टार्टिंग, वी यूज द स्टार्टर, और वी नीड सम डिवाइस नोन एज द स्टार्टर. Because of the high armature current, the additional resistance is placed in the armature circuit at starting. The starting resistance of the machine is cut out of the circuit when the machine gains its speeds. The armature current of a motor is given by normally hum kya karte hain armature resistance hamara low hota hai in case of DC machine to usme additional alag se resistance connect kar dete hain series with the armature circuit aur resistance ko starting mein dheere dheere cut off karte jate hain jaise jaise hamari speed badhti jati hai to resistance kya karta hai starting current ko oppose karta hai aur jo machine hai wo safely hamari start hoti hai by using starter और अगर स्टार्टर का हम यूज नहीं करते तो हैवी करंट जो है वो फ्लो हो जाएगी जिससे कि हमारा फील्ड और आर्मेचर सर्किट जो है वो डैमेज हो सकता है बर्नआउट हो सकता है सो आईए इज इक्वल टू वी माइनस ई डिवाइडेड बाय आर ए हमने एक फॉर्मूला पढ़ा था वी इज इक्वल टू ई बी माइनस ऑफ आई ए इंटू आर ए उसी से हमने आईए का इक्वेशन निकाला है सो आर्मेचर करंट आईए इज इक्वल टू वी माइनस ऑफ ई डिवाइडेड बाय आरए इक्वेशन नंबर वन वेयर आईए इज कॉल्ड द आर्मेचर करंट वी इज कॉल्ड द अप्लाइड वोल्टेज ई इज कॉल्ड इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ और बैक ईएमएफ एंड आरए इज कॉल्ड द आर्मेचर रेजिस्टेंस Thus, IA depends upon E and RA. If the V kept constant, when the motor is first switched on, the armature is stationary. Hence, the back EMF EV is also zero. The initial starting armature current IAS is given by the equation. IAS means starting armature current. IAS is called starting armature current is equal to V minus of zero because back EMF जो है उसकी value हमारी zero है तो V minus zero divided by RA is equal to V upon RA. Equation number two. Since the armature resistance of the motor is very small, generally less than 1 ohm, therefore the starting armature current IAS would be very large. For example, if a motor with the armature resistance of 0.5 ohms is connected directly to a 230 volt supply, then by putting the value of the equation number 2, so we get IAS means starting armature current is equal to V upon RA is equal to put the value V is equal to 230 volt and RA is equal to 0.5 ohm. Is equal to 460 amperes. It's a very high current or very high or large starting current. This large current would be damage the brushes, commutator and windings. So हमें क्या करना है स्टार्टिंग करंट जो इतनी हाई है इसको हमें कम करना है स्टार्टिंग में सो वी नीड सम डिवाइस नोन एज स्टार्टर स्टार्टर का यूज हम करते हैं स्टार्टर में कुछ भी नहीं होता है रेजिस्टेंस सीरीज में लगा होता है स्टार्टिंग में रेजिस्टेंस फुल रेजिस्टेंस कनेक्टेड रहता है जैसे जैसे स्पीड बढ़ती जाती है वैसे वैसे रेजिस्टेंस जो है वो कट ऑफ होता जाता है स्टार्टर हम अभी देखेंगे नेक्स्ट वाले क्लास में 3 पॉइंट 4 पॉइंट एंड 2 पॉइंट स्टार्टर As the motor speed increase, the back EMF increase. The difference V minus E go on decreasing. This result in a gradual decrease of armature current until the motor attain its stable speed. and the corresponding back EMF. Under this condition, the armature current reaches its desired value. Thus, it is found that the back EMF helps the armature resistance in limiting the current through the armature. Since at the time of starting the DC motor, the starting current is very large. At the time of starting of all DC motors, except for the very small motors, an extra resistance must be connected in series with the armature. This extra resistance is added so that a safe value of the motor is maintained and to limit the starting current until the motor has attained its stable speed. तो हम क्या करते हैं, स्टार्टिंग करंट को प्रिवेंट करने के लिए, इस लार्ज करंट से मशीन को प्रिवेंट करने के लिए, वी नीड अ डिवाइस नोन एज स्टार्टर. स्टार्टर लगाते हैं. स्टार्टर में रेजिस्टेंस सीरीज में कनेक्टेड होता है. रेजिस्टेंस क्या करता है, स्टार्टिंग करंट को लिमिट करता है और हमारी मशीन को सेफली स्टार्ट करता है. The series resistance is divided into sections which are cut out one by one. As the speed of the motor rise and the back EMF builds up, the extra resistance is cut out when the speed of the motor pulls up to its normal value. जब मशीन अपनी रेटेड स्पीड में चलने लगती है तो सारा का सारा उस टाइम पे रेजिस्टेंस जो है वो कट ऑफ हो जाता है स्टार्टर का. सो नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट टू पॉइंट स्टार्टर. थ्री पॉइंट स्टार्टर एंड फोर पॉइंट स्टार्टर. नेक्स्ट वाले लेक्चर में हम देखेंगे कि टू पॉइंट स्टार्टर, थ्री पॉइंट स्टार्टर और फोर पॉइंट स्टार्टर क्या होता है विथ सर्किट डायग्राम एंड विथ इट्स वर्किंग. सो फाइनली द रेफरेंस ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन. So these are the references. Electrical Technology by B.L. Thareja, ElectricalEasy.com, Electrical for You and Circuit Globes, etc. So, thanks for watching the video.